Okay, this is going to be a demonstration of how the NVH app works and how it can help you diagnose vibrations on your vehicle. The first thing you want to do is open the NVH app, hit agree. This is just a warning, a safety warning, and then it'll let you pick your vehicle from a list of manufacturers. So we're driving a Subaru right now, so we're going to hit Subaru 2015. We're in a Legacy 2.5 liter engine. Now, a lot of this information is already filled out for you by the app, but it asks you for your tire size. If you're not sure how to find that, there's a link here in the app that will give you instructions on how to find that. So we're gonna enter in our tire size and then hit start. As soon as you hit start, it takes you to the vehicle view that will show you where the vibrations are coming from. Now the app uses the phone's internal sensors to measure the vibration and tell you where that vibration is coming from. But it needs to be able to feel that vibration, so we're going to attach it to the car using this window phone holder here, which is securely attached to the window so that the phone will vibrate along with the vehicle. Now, as you can see here on the app screen, as soon as we put the phone in the holder, the tires started glowing red. They glow a bright red, which means that the app has already, it's feeling right now that there's a tire vibration. Now there's a few different ways to see the vibrations. We're in vehicle view right now. You can also switch to the live graph, which gives you a bar graph of all the different types of vibrations that are possible on your car. And the bar goes up and down based on the strength of the vibration. The third view is this live data view that tells you the exact frequencies that are being detected, and then also gives you their amplitudes in all three axes. Most people like this vehicle view the most. Now there's this button up here. When you go on a road test, you're going to want to attach the phone to the car using some device like this, or you can even just hold it against the dashboard or window, and then hit start recording up here in the corner. Now, once we've hit start recording, the app is going to record everything that it's sensing, everything that it's diagnosing right now. And then you just want to go and drive the vehicle at a steady speed, at the speed where you can feel the vibration. So if you don't feel the vibration until 70 miles an hour, you want to go get on the freeway and drive at 70 miles an hour. It's important that you maintain a steady speed while you're recording, so that the app can get some good data. Now, when you're done, when you've gone on a road test, when you're satisfied that you felt the vibration and that the app has had time, and it doesn't need much time to feel the vibration, you can hit this stop recording button, and it gives you an option, a chance to name the recording. So we'll just name it test and save. Now, it'll take a little bit to save. It'll take longer if it's a longer recording. And then the first thing that pops up is the screen that tells you what the app, what the diagnosis is. So this right here says that the app has detected a first order tire speed related vibration. Now you can tap on this link here, how do I fix this vibration? And up pops steps and sort of a guide, a troubleshooting guide on what to do to fix that this type of vibration that it was detected. So if we go back to this analysis here, there are three options. So this auto tab here just tells you what it thinks the vibration is. And then you can go to the totals tab that shows you every vibration that was detected during the recording. During this test, it only detected a first order tire vibration. So we're pretty confident that that is the problem. And then if you tap on here, and it tells you how many times it was detected and the average amplitude. If you tap on this, it will give you a breakdown of what speeds it was detected at. So it was detected 18 times between 60 and 64 miles per hour and 66 times between 65 and 69 miles per hour. So if we go back, there's also a graph that will graph the amplitude of the vibration over time. And if there are multiple vibrations, multiple lines will show up on here. So that is how you can diagnose vibration problems on your vehicles using the NVH app.